Welcome back to Let's Play... I was about to say A Tear of a Million. Song of the Ocean. Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. He's with us again now. McBean, so... Did I talk to all these people again? Can't miss the concert. McBean was flirting with her. You think President Maritos is cool? A working woman should be like her. Oh, I can't get back there, but... Yeah, we... heard some of that. Yeah, I read that. Okay. Did I check up here? Yeah. We are proud of the Maritos Group, and it is my reason for living. Yeah. Okay. Alright, so a couple things. We have to head back to the weapon shop to see if McBean could use one of those gloves. At the town hall, I was reading through the books there because I have a separate book series that I do. And I found a book that I had missed. So we need to formally, quote-unquote, find that book. Cavaro's elevated waterway and the International Theater are wonderful, but most of all, this whole city is clean. I have seen many places through my journey, but I feel that this place is being made conscious of people's eyes. I remember her saying that. Yeah, nothing new here. Yep. So to get to the other part of the city, it's blindly through the back there. That's nothing new. Let's see if the bread guy has anything to say. Chestnut bread is very popular. As soon as it's done baking, it's sold out, so I can only run taste tests. I think it's time for me to hire someone to help me. Head man Matthew. He's the head man bread man. So there was nothing up here before, or, well, nobody up here. And it's the same. Yeah, these signs say anything new. I'm surprised. It's not a good feeling to see only my husband having fun, so let me have fun too. Look at this! I bought a ticket of Stardust Cantata. Are you jealous? No, because we also have a ticket. Otherwise, we'd be mad jealous and we'd have to kill you and hide your body. And take the ticket. That's just how we roll, you know. Here's the town hall. The swamp spreads in the south of Cavaro. It's a dangerous place that lightning strikes all the time. Even the citizens of Cavaro don't get near it. I wouldn't recommend going to the swamp. Well, we have to go to the swamp. It's Seems like there are more numerous soldiers walking in the town. It's not a good sign. I have to raise my voice to the embassy. Why are they hard of hearing? Huh. Captain of Numeros. I don't understand why the Captain of Numeros is talking to him friendly. It's a weird way of saying it. Captain of Numeros, says McBean? They said they came here to research the swamp. What kind of research do you do in a swamp? How suspicious. We'd better take an caution, since we are dealing with greedy opponents like Rish and the Numeros Empire, but I don't understand why the mayor was talking with the captain of Numeros friendly. You have a weird way of putting things. Oh, her. How did you like Cavaro? It's quite a city, wasn't it? It still is. Okay, so here's this book over here. Now it shows up. Just because I was standing here and we only saw this one. And what happened was... I left... Bear with me. I had left and was going... I think I was looking for Grandma Coon's place. And then running along the wall here, I could see... another book. So that's how I came across it. Not even in the room, but outside the room. It was easier to see. So technically, I was closer to it. So, because this one is Local History 2, Ancient Cedars. And this is Local History 1, Backbone of the Great Serpent. I'll just quickly read it. It's like three or four sentences long. That's it. Local History 1, Backbone of the Great Serpent. The giant mountain range in the north is called the Backbone of the Great Serpent. This long mountain range prevents us from reaching the world to the north. Many adventurers have tried to go over the Backbone of the Great Serpent, but none have ever succeeded. Therefore, it's unknown what the other side of the Backbone of the Great Serpent is actually like. And that's it. There's no reason to continue the book because it's unknown. Whoa, I give up. I'm too sleepy. Sorry. What? I wish I could do something like that. The only problem is that there's hardly any visitors here. That's why I can't help falling asleep. All the elevated waterways are connected with 9 drain tunnels to the outside. So fresh and cold water is running in the elevated waterway all the time. Alright, that's that. How did I get it? How do I get over there? Yeah, this place is closed off. Like, there's not even any side passages. We have to just leave and find our way from here, I guess. Which we cannot do from there. Alright, not even. There's the bread. It's just a little complicated finding your way around, unfortunately. Oops. Like the water flows, the time passes, and the city will change. But I like Cavaro because it always shoots for improvement. Seems vaguely familiar. I might have read that one. Alright, where's the weapon shop? See, that's why... Now we have to run all the way back, because I want to go to the... some other area. Old man gets in the way. Maybe it is in that part of town. I keep falling through. Is this Grandma Coon's place again? Yeah, I guess it's down in the other section. Alright. What do you want to do, Grandpa? Well, we have more time until we leave Cavaro, so let's come back again. Yeah, he wasn't with us the last time. Elf Filden was a lot bigger. I do want to check in here. Let's check in here first. Oh, we're gonna come from the stage. They love that. You just wait and see, Grandpa. I don't give a damn about a troubadour, says Wolf. We, the musicians from the International Theater with a solid spirit as performers, are the only ones who know true music. McBain says, young man, you're so strong-headed. Remember Leon. He was a performer as well as a troubadour who would travel all over the realms. That's true, but... There are things you can understand that first time you travel. What does that mean? How do you do, Mr. McBain? I'm a Teodora cellist. You're a Teodora? How do you do? But how come all the female musicians at the International Theater are beautiful without any exception? I'm flattered, but I'm a performer. I would like to hear compliments after the performance. I see. I'm looking forward to it. I'll do my best to show my performance, so I hope you'll enjoy it. Long time no see, Mr. McBain. Since Riatom Island, says McBain, I heard that you're going to perform Leon's Stardust Cantata. I'm looking forward to it. Don't get me nervous. I would like to perform well enough to live up to Leon's piece. Bunny girl. Mr. McBain, it's so good to see you again. You look good. You're as beautiful as ever, Wendy. I'm so jealous with the people in Cavaro. You're such a smooth talker. Please make yourself at home. Okay. Now there's another group of people. I just like it where you can drop down. I don't know why. There's another group of people... on the other side. Concert of Diva and the Cavaro Trio, huh? Moreover, they are going to perform Stardust Cantata, the dream opera. I can't wait. I want to be a good enough musician to be able to perform at the special concert. I gotta practice harder. All the musicians who gather here in the International Theater are top-notch, but especially among them, Cavaro Trio is supremely gifted. I would love to catch up with them no matter what. I remember him saying something about catch up. Alright, let's check the roof again, why not? Alright, there's this floor that, like, nobody is on, seems. Yeah. Yeah. All right. I'll get back down. Alright, I'm gonna find this weapon shop. And then we can go to the swamp. Down to the swamp. Aha! Severing sword. Shadow glove is what he has. Oh, fighter glove is better. Hope this doesn't injure. Actually, I just want to see if it says anything. You wouldn't think silk could have immense destruction power. Probably magical. Alright, so let's hope this doesn't hurt him when he uses it. It says with experience, so maybe you have to be a certain level of experience to not get injured. Fighter glove. I'm not getting rid of the other sword because... just in case. But we will sell the shadow glove. This guy. Oh, this is that same bar, or? Alright, let us save the game. Because we're gonna stride into danger. Swamp. I said lightning strikes around here. Oh, is that dismal kind of theme. I like it. Oops. I didn't mean to hit that. Pseudo flower and armored beetle. Everyone on the pseudo flower, except Jan and Rick, might not be able to hit, so we'll do the armored beetle. And I think we might get to go again, because we surprise the enemy. Yeah, that enemy wasn't willing to fight us. And that's why. getting soaking wet, man. Didn't bring our umbrella this time. So we got a path going that way, and then we got... I'll fight them. Why not? Trying to go around it, but... See, the problem is they keep pushing it further and further away. He couldn't go. Uno will be able to shoot. There we go. That's like twice that I didn't mean to attack. Or enter combat. So, well, okay, that goes to a different screen. So, where does the other path go? All over. Apparently. Does this go off the screen too? Oh no, there's chest. Nice. An emerald. Orb of Ocean 24. Because we're not good at emptying chests. The other side of the chest. You found an Orb of Ocean 25 on the floor. Huh. That's so funny. 24 and 25. Serious Altos. Alto shouting. Wait, which side is the front? I guess this side is. We got a flip cape. What's a flip cape? Accessories? Fashionable cape made by suede whips off attacks to increase your defense. Alright, see if we can equip this on somebody. I mean, we're all kind of full. Okay, this increases the defense by 4 points. Okay. And is that it? Okay. Alright, so we're free to go. To hit the two monsters hanging around here. One. Oh, and just one. We're traveling down like this is the hardest to avoid. You don't get a lot of lead time. Just start running into things. It was very lush over here. Damn. I don't know where I'm going. Look at that thing. Things are all afraid of us. This is where we came in? Yeah. Yeah, man, yeah. Chest. Kung Fu Knuckle. Is that for McBean? No, Dead End Island. Glove with lead sewn in a wave line. The enemy may get confused. Oh, Confuse Knuckle. Makes sense then. Not as good as the fighter glove. So it's something to sell. So this. Okay. Okay, so now I have to wonder, does anything we missed? Looking to see if there are any more chests like that. Leash Bottle M. Okay, that's the medium form of replenishing your mana potion. I think that's it. Wait, is this something we can go around as well? Oh no. Oh, maybe we can go this way. Okay. That looks like a very important dock. Look, this goes up here. This is not a different area of the map, just... I don't think it is. Little boardwalks. Forte says, huh? Grandpa. We are surrounded, says McBean. What? Says Una. What are you guys doing? What can I do for you? McBean asks. Oh, it's Palman. Says, excuse me, wrong person. Una says, you are... I met you at the lakeside, says Palman. Actually, I haven't told my name yet. I'm Palman. We're the troubadours, as you can see, says McBean. The McBean Company. poem and says, "We are the investigators of Numero's empire. We are researching the swamp." You look like you're doing more than researching the swamp. Why is that? You just said wrong person, says Forte. I don't think surrounding the people who enter the swamp is called research. Haha, you're right. I'm sorry. By the way, how come you guys came to such a place? McBain says, depending on the reason, we might have to be hostile to each other? No, don't worry. Our unit will never attack civilians. I'm relieved to hear that, says McBain. I don't want to wield a sword towards anyone if I don't have to. You don't use a sword, McBain. If we tell you why we are here, will you tell me who we were mistaken for? It's not possible. Since it's such a terrible weather, I'll show you to our camp. Okay. I see, says McBain. It's a pretty good campsite. Thank you for the delicious tea, says Forte. It was delicious, Una says. McBain says, well, regarding the reason why we came here, there are two reasons. Don't tell him. He says it's not possible. Why are you going to tell him now? He's not going to tell us anything in return. One was to go to the Lightning Shrine. I've heard the rumor of the shrine. That is the shrine that the people stopped going to because of the danger of the lightning, right? Yes, says Forte. We have some business to take care of at the shrine. We are looking for something. We heard that it is in the shrine. That's why we came here. Would you mind me asking what it is? No, says McBain. It's a stone that the legendary musician Leon left. A stone? It's not a mere stone for me. It's a precious stone left by a musician I look up to. There's more than one stone hidden all over the world, says Una. Forte says, a part of the musical score is carved in the back of each stone. If we collect all of the stones, they complete a piece of music. I really want to listen to that music piece, says McBain. That's why I'm traveling with them looking for the stones. That means you've already collected several already? There's a lot of already's. Yeah, we've been looking all over since we started our journey from Literatudo. I told you my story. It's your turn to tell me why you are at the swamp. He said it's not possible, though. We are researching the construction of a calling port. We're investigating to see if it's possible to build a port on the swamp. Considering the only way to load at Cavaro is to use either Polka in the east or Giraffe in the west to dock a boat, we are planning to give a helping hand in order to develop the international trade. We've received permission from Mayor DeMille of Cavaro to stay here as well. I see, says McBain. Your story makes sense so far. I know you have more reasons than that, but I guess we don't have any right or obligation to find out what they are. It's a wise judgment, Pullman says. And what's your other reason? Huh? You said there were two reasons why you came to the swamp, but I only heard one of them. Well, we were wondering if a lady with black hair has come here or not. He's looking for her. I saw her at the lake, Wyalina and Cavaro, and was only hoping that she was the spirit of the shrine while we were looking for a stone. Have you ever seen her? I'm afraid not. Really? That's too bad. Anyway, we need to get going to head to the shrine. Okay, says Forte. Mr. McBain, says Palman. Yes? It's dangerous near the lightning shrine because there are many lightning strikes occurring. Please be very careful. I'll leave the next tent open, so please use it freely. That sounds good. Thank you very much.